Hi, I'm Rachel Wallwork, one of the third-year rheumatology fellows. I'm here to tell you about our work looking at an antibody called anti-Sjogren syndrome scleroderma autoantigen 1, or anti-SSSCA1, in cancer in patients with scleroderma. We're discovering more and more that there are subgroups of patients with systemic sclerosis who have an increased cancer risk. These subgroups can be identified by their autoantibodies. For example, we know that patients who are anti-RNA polymerase 3 positive have greater cancer risk around the time of scleroderma onset compared to those who are anti-RNA polymerase 3 negative. Understanding the associations between antibodies and cancer allows us to target more intensive cancer screening to patients at greatest risk. Our study was developed because it was known that anti-SSSCA1 antibodies had been found in patients with systemic sclerosis, and new data suggested that the target of this antibody, the antigen SSSCA1, might be important in cancer development. This made us wonder if these antibodies may be markers for patients at risk of cancer. So to investigate this further, we selected patients with cancer and those without cancer from the Johns Hopkins Scleroderma Center Research Registry to evaluate whether they had these antibodies. We included 209 patients with a history of cancer and 205 patients without a history of cancer in our study. We then looked to see if these antibodies, the anti-SSSCA1 antibodies, were more likely in patients with a history of cancer. And overall, we found that 7% of the sample had anti-SSSCA1 antibodies, therefore were anti-SSSCA1 antibody positive, and that patients with these antibodies had a 2.5 times higher odds of cancer than those without the antibodies after controlling for other cancer risk factors, such as older age of onset, the anti-RNA polymerase 3 antibodies, among others. When we looked at the timing of the cancers compared to when the scleroderma developed, we learned that the cancers occurred later, suggesting that these antibodies may provide some anti-tumor immunity and delay the clinical cancer development. We also found that patients with these antibodies have more cardiac involvement and more severe Raynaud's than those who are anti-SSSCA1 negative. So further research needs to validate these findings, make sure that they're true in larger groups of patients, and explore when these antibodies develop in the course of disease. Are they stable over time, or do we need to test repeatedly in order to find them? Thank you so much for your time.